Hello friends, welcome again to my channel Physics for You. And here today we are going to learn about the diamond structure and the NaCl structure, that is sodium chloride structure, right? So these two are familiar words for our diamond, everybody know at least by word, and NaCl everybody is eating every day, so that's why it is what the salt, sodium chloride, it is also familiar to everyone. But we don't know what exactly the internal structure of diamond, what exactly the internal structure of our sodium salt or simply the sodium chloride, okay. So in the last video we have seen about the structures of the we have seen about the packing fraction of FCC, BCC and simple cubic and all, right. So same is here also, we have to find what is packing fraction of diamond structure also, how diamond is closely packed or loosely packed, that's what we have to see, right. And moreover, generally we say diamond is the toughest material, so we have to see the internal structure of diamond is how tough, okay. So obviously they do not have any relation, it does not matter that the whether it is closed pack or loosely packed, but after all it is the toughest material, right. And yes, the same is true for our NaCl also, we will find the packing fraction for NaCl also, right. Okay, so yes, this is what our channel Physics for You, and today's lecture BSc TY semester 5, and it is under the unit crystal structure, first unit, and I think yes, the last topic you can say the diamond and NaCl structure, okay. So let's begin. First of all we'll see the diamond structure, okay. So you have seen four diagrams on the screen, and you might got confused which is the true diagram or which is the correct diagram. So all diagrams are correct, only the little bit changes in the side or viewpoint, and as well as the colors and little bit what the outline, right. So this is what the diamond structure, this is also diamond structure, this is also diamond structure, and this is a side view, simply one face I can see, and then how I look the diamond structure, that is what I hear. And yes, in between you have seen some numbers, so those numbers are nothing but the exact distance from the corner point, we can say it as the distance, I will explain later on. But first of all, diamond is a cubic structure, first thing, it is a cubic structure, okay. Moreover, it is a cubic structure such that, and it contains all carbon atoms. Diamond is a pure carbon, so it contains all carbon atoms, and carbon atoms such that every carbon atom in a unit cell is surrounded by four different carbon atoms. So this is what the structure, in simple language we can say how to explain the diamond structure. It contains the carbon atoms, and carbon atoms are arranged in such a manner that every carbon atom is surrounded by four different carbon atoms, okay. So yes, how it is possible, how to draw such a structure, right. You might got the scare, yes, how to draw this structure, but yes, in simple form we can say this is what the simplest structure we can draw, okay. So in other words we can say diamond, how to form the diamond structure, if we take the two face centered cubic structures, we know now what is face centered cubic structure, it is a cubic structure, but on six faces we have six atoms at the center point of face, right. So if we take the two face center cubic structures or unit cell, two FCC unit cell I will say, two FCC unit cell, and if we interpenetrate into each other via body diagonal, once again, now let us consider you have two FCC structures in your hand, and those FCC structures you have to interpenetrate into each other, you have to interpenetrate into each other, but via body diagonal, right, because both the unit cells are cubic in structure and they have a body diagonal, so obviously two body diagonals, select any one body diagonal and you have to interpenetrate, that means you have to merge those two unit cells, which unit cells, FCC, merge those two FCC unit cells such that the merging should along the body diagonal, okay. And up to what point you have to merge, you have to merge only up to 1/4 distance from the corner atom, yes, because I am merging two FCC unit cell via body diagonal, means I am passing through this corner atom of this unit cell and this corner atom of this unit cell, so I have to merge such that now these two unit cells I have arranged or I have touched each other and merging, now yes, I am merging. So up to what distance you have to merge, yes, up to up to 1/4 distance only from the corner atom. And yes, that combination you can consider as a diamond structure. This is how the simple way to draw or to understand a diamond crystal structure. Okay, right. And yes, whatever I told here, it is written, it is completely formed by carbon atoms. Every carbon atom is surrounded by 4 other carbon atoms situated at the corners of regularly tetrahedral by a covalent linkage. Yes, bonding, which bond is there, we have mentioned. In next unit we will see about the bonding in detail, but right now just remember all the carbon atoms are bonded with a covalent bond, right? Okay. And the diamond cubic structure is a combination of two interpenetrating means mixing into each other, interpenetrating FCC, face center cubic structure sublattices displaced along the body diagonal of the cubic cell by 1/4 length of the diagonal. 1/4 length of that diagonal means 1/4 distance from the corner atom. Yes, the whole diagonal is like this and it starts from the corner atom only. So, we can say 1/4 distance from a corner atom. You have to interpenetrate one FCC into another other FCC unit cell till or up to 1/4 distance of a body diagonal. Okay, and then finally, if we look into the structure, you will find such a structure, or you will find such a structure three-dimensionally, and by two-dimensionally, we can say from one side, I will find like this. Okay, these likewise, if I look into one face, so likewise, you will find the structure of diamond. Okay. Right. Now, next task is what we have to find, its packing fraction, effective number of atoms and all know. Okay. So, to find the packing fraction, we must know effective number of atoms. That means, how many number of atoms are completely or volume number of atoms are present in the diamond unit cell. So, this is what the unit cell of diamond, and we have to see how many number of atoms are involved here. So, by looking at the structure only, or simply here we have said diamond is a cubic structure. So, from that only we can say 8 atoms are present at 8 corners, no doubt. Okay. Again, since 2 face center cubic cells are involved, that means yes, there are atoms at face center, means yes, 6 atoms at 6 face. You can see this is what the face center atom at bottom. This is face center from that side, this is the face center atom for this side, this is the face center atom for the top side, this is face center atom for that side. Here also this blue color atom, face center atom, this is face center atom. And in this diagram, if you look carefully, the green color, how many green color atoms? 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, these 4 green color atoms are completely present in that unit cell only. That means, as like our body centered cubic cell, in body centered we have one atom completely present in unit cell. So, here 4 atoms are present in unit cell, as we have seen in case of hexagonal closed pack structure HCP, there are 3 atoms completely present in unit cell. So, here 4 atoms are completely present in unit cell. So, what we got, how many atoms are involved? 8 corner atoms, 6 face center atoms and 4 internal atoms. Okay. 3 possibilities only, right? So, let us go to the calculation part. Now, how to find the total effective number of atoms? So, just I told you 8 atoms are present at 8 corners. So, obviously, each and every corner atom is shared by 8 different unit cell. That is why we must divide it by 8, or we must multiply it by 1/8, because that unit cell contains 1/8 part of each corner atom. That is why 1/8 × 8. So, the in all corner atoms contribute only 1 effective number of atom. Okay, yes, we know this from simple cubic structure. Again, face center, 6 face center atoms are there, and yes, already we know every face center atom is shared by 2 different unit cell, that unit cell and its neighboring unit cell. Okay, so obviously we should divide it by 2. So, 6 × 1/2 or 6/2, it gives you 3. Yes, and one more possibility or one more chance is there, one more category of atoms are present there, and those are completely present in the unit cell only. There are 4 more atoms inside the structure. So, that means this 1 plus 3 plus those 4 atoms, 1 plus 3 plus 4, and that is equal to 8. So, what we got here is the effective number of atoms in diamond structure are 8. Okay, yes. So yes, this number is more as compared to our simple cubic, BCC and FCC and HCP also. In HCP we got 6 effective number of atoms, but here we got 8 effective number of atoms, right. Now, since each carbon atom is surrounded by the 4 more carbon atoms, the coordination number is 4. Yes, what is coordination number? We know that coordination number means number of atoms for a atom to which it is bonded. So, each carbon atom, I told you, each carbon atom is surrounded by 4 different carbon atoms. That means each carbon atom is bonded with 4 different carbon atoms. That means its coordination number is 4. Okay, right. Now, we got these two things. First important is now effective number of atoms, that is important for our packing fraction calculation, and it is 8. Okay, and coordination number is 4. Lastly, we will see the coordination number for all the unit cells, but here we have written. Okay, now go to the atomic radius, because we know we must find two things to get the AF atomic packing fraction. So, first we got effective number of atoms, and next is the relation between atomic radius and the lattice parameter A, or simply we can say we must know atomic radius. So, to find atomic radius, just go to the next diagram. Okay, now this diagram, I hope you can see this diagram. I have given this as X, here it is Y, Z, and here it is W. So, these are the both triangles are the right angle triangles, even though it is shown by the angle, it is not shown right angle, but yes, it is a right angle triangle, and those angles are taken from this particular structure. Yes, among the from this structure, internally or externally, you can take any face and you will find such a structure, and from that, yes. Now, this particular side, so this is one atom, this is one atom, and yes, that is why I have given this is 2r. Now, here for the atomic radius, we have considered small r. In previous cases, we have considered capital R, but here we have considered small r. Okay. So, this is what by default 2r, because here 2 atoms are involved, and yes, if we draw a little bit bigger like this, so that is what 2r, as in case of simple cubic, A is equal to 2r. But here directly we cannot say A is equal to 2r. We have to take first of all the help of this triangle. And yes, from this corner atom, this atom is penetrated by how much distance? A by 4. We know that because what we have said? Yes, we have to penetrate one unit cell into another till or up to the distance, 1/4 distance of our body diagonal. So, it is A by 4, and this is also A by 4. Now, if we talk about this particular triangle, X, Y, W, it is a right angle triangle, and from that triangle only we have written X, Y square is equal to X, W square plus W, Y square, X, Y square. Now, see, this X, Y square is a hypotenuse with respect to this lower triangle. X, Y square is equal to W, Y square plus X, W square, because A by 4 is X, W, and again A by 4 is YW. So, from this we can directly say, since XW is also A by 4 and YW is also A by 4. So, A by 4 square plus A by 4 square. So, obviously, A square by 16 again plus A square by 16, and it gets A square divided by or 2A square divided by 16, that means A square divided by 8. Okay. Just cancel the 2 with 16. So, left hand side xy square as it is, keep xy square as it is left hand side, and that we got A square divided by 8. Okay. And now, look at this bigger triangle again, because this xy square was unknown to us, and therefore, we went for the lower triangle first. From that we got xy square. Now, use that xy square. Now, this xy square and this yz square corresponding to this triangle, xz is the hypotenuse. XZ is the hypotenuse, right? This angle is the right angle triangle. XYZ is the right angle triangle. And now we got this XY as a base and this YZ as a height and this as a hypotenuse. So, again from that also by the Pythagoras theorem, XZ square we can write is equal to XY square plus YZ square. So, XZ square, what is XZ? Yes, 2R square, or for a while just keep XZ square only. XY square we have found just right now, XY square is A square by 8, substitute here. YZ square, YZ is again A by 4, so A by 4 it's a square. So, A by 4 it's a square means A square divided by 16, and A square by 8 in addition. So in if we do this addition, then we got 3 a square by 16, a square by 8 plus a square by 16. If we add together, we got 3 a square by 16, and left hand side it is x z square. Okay, but what is xz? It is 2r. Xz is 2r. So yes, substitute again here. So xz is equal to 2r, and right hand side as it is 3a square divided by 16. 2r it's a square. That means 4r square is equal to 3a square divided by 16. And finally, if we multiply this 4 in denominator, and then it is r square is equal to 3a square numerator as it is divided by 64. R square to the left side, and again a square to the right side. You can take here square root. If we take the square root, 3 will go into the under root. R square is, R is the square root of R, and a is the square root of a square, and in the denominator 64's square root is 8. So finally, we got the relation small r, that is atomic radius, is equal to under root 3a divided by 8. Under root 3a divided by 8. Yes, this relation we have calculated in a very simple manner for our previous cases, but here little bit complication. We have to take the help of these lower triangle to find first of all xy, and once we get the xy, then we use same Pythagoras theorem in upper triangle, and from that we can get the radius and the atomic, that is parameter relation, that is r is equal to under root 3a divided by 8. Okay. Now, yes, we got this relation and we got the effective number of atoms in the previous slide only. Now, you can go for the atomic packing factor. Yes. So, atomic packing factor V divided by V. Small v is the volume of atoms, and capital V in the denominator, that is volume of unit cell. Okay. So, firstly, we will go to the volume of atoms. So, what is volume of atom? Because how many number of atoms? So, total volume of atoms, one atom volume 4 by 3 pi r cube, because atom is in spherical shape. And how many such atoms are there? 8 atoms. So, atom of volume of atoms is 8 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay. But here let us substitute the value of r. Just we got the value of r, and which is in terms of small a, that is root 3 a divided by 8, and it is a cube. Okay. After substituting the value, and yes, if you do this calculation, and yes, so what we got is pi under root 3 by 16, and that is equal to 0.34. And what? Yes, you can say, sir, what about the volume of unit cell? Because unit cell is a cube. Yes, at the very first slide only we said, or we have concluded, or we know that the diamond is a cubic structure. So cubic structure, the and or whose side is a, so that's why it's a cube or volume of cube is a cube. So this a cube here we have written in denominator, and this a cube from this value of r. So, this a cube, a p cube get cancelled, and if we cancel all the things, we get under root 3 pi by 16, and if we substitute the value of pi, and if we take the value of root 3, that is 1.73, and do this calculation and divide it by 16, then we get 0.34, and in terms of percentage, it is 34%. So, 34% is a very less packing fraction as compared to our simple cubic. Also simple cubic, how much we got? Do you remember? It is 52%. For body centered cubic, it is 68%, and for face centered cubic and HCP, hexagonal closed pack, we got 74%, and it is simply 34%. So, even though we say the diamond is the toughest material, but its packing fraction is very, very less as compared to other different crystal structures or crystal unit cells. It is 34%, and therefore, we can say diamond is a loosely packed structure. Okay, for hexagonal, we call HCP, hexagonal closely packed, closed pack. So, here it is loosely packed, because its packing fraction is just 34%, or packing efficiency is 34%. So, what we can say, in one diamond cubic unit cell, 34% part is only filled with atoms, and remaining, how much remaining? Remaining 66%. Yes, I am correct? Yes, 66% part is empty or a void space, and this is how we can find the packing fraction or packing efficiency for diamond structure. Okay, right. Now, I think we should stop here and we will go, or yes, we will continue, because the for NaCl structure we do not have to work more, because NaCl is a face centered cubic unit cell, and for face centered cubic structure already we found the all the things. So, simply directly we can say NaCl here, Na here the diagram is likewise. So, it is a face centered cubic. So, at every face we have at the every face centered we have one atom, yes, this blue color atom we can say that is Cl, and Na positive and Cl negative, yes, because we know that these forms the ionic bonds, they forms a ionic bonds, and this what we got the face centered cube NaCl structure. So, simply as we said for the diamond structure, diamond is a cubic unit cell. So, here it is face centered cubic unit cell, diamond was simply cubic, here it is face centered cubic. So, for face centered cubic we know effective number of atoms are 4, because eight corner atoms combinedly gives effective number 1, and again 6 faces, each and every face atom is shared by 2 different unit cell, that means 6 faces in all gives you 3 effective number of atoms. So, 1 plus 3 totally 4 effective number of atoms, right. And since for the face center cubic we found atomic radius, that means the relation between A and the R, and finally we got this 74%. So, if we have to write in detail the NaCl packing fraction, you please just write as we have written for face centered cubic, because yes, it is a face centered cubic structure. So, for face centered cubic structure we have drawn everything. So, simply here to understand or to distinguish between the atoms which is the Na and which is the Cl, we have drawn like this, Na shown by the red color and Cl is shown by, or Cl atoms are shown by the blue color. Here yes, little bit similarly Na are these what we can say the dark green colors are the Na atoms, and whatever may be these little bit smaller and little bit yellowish in color, those are the Cl atoms. So, this is what about the NaCl, that is sodium chloride structure. So, and if we calculate for the packing fraction for the FCC, we know it is 74%. So, yes, it is not a loosely packed structure, NaCl is a closely packed structure, but diamond is a loosely packed structure and whose atomic packing factor is only 34% and coordination number is 4. For FCC the coordination number is more, right. So, let us talk about the coordination number in the last slide, or we can say the summary of our all the FCC, BCC and HCP and diamond and NaCl we can say. Here yes, for the atomic radius we have, for simple cubic we got the relation between R and A. So, simply I will write, we have written there in terms of A, here we have written in terms of R, that is why we called it as atomic radius or simply radius. So, here for simple cubic it is A by 2, number of atoms in simple cubic are only 1, and its packing fraction we got pi by 6, that is 52%. For body centered cubic atomic radius is root 3 by 4, and for body center cubic how many atoms are present effectively, only 2, one at the body center position, and from 8 corner atoms only 1, and yes, finally, we got root 3 pi by 8, that is what 68% for the BCC packing factor for BCC. For FCC root 2 by A by 4, it is radius, 4 number of atoms are present effectively in one unit cell, and root 2 by 6, it is what 74% is what the face center cubic crystal structures atomic packing factor. And for diamond just we found root 3 A by 8 is the radius and 8 effective number of atoms, and what we got the packing factor, it is root 3 pi divided by 16, it is 34%. And in this smaller picture I have shown these one more extra column, and that is for coordination number. For simple cubic how many how much is the coordination number, 6. Six coordination number means in simple cubic each atom is bonded with 6 different atoms, that is what the meaning of coordination number. Okay. For BCC each atom is shared, or each atom is bonded, or each atom is connected with different 8 atoms, that is what coordination number. Okay. And for FCC the coordination number is 12. In face centered cubic each and every atom is bonded with different 12 atoms, in one unit cell. So that is what we call, or moreover, not in one unit cell. If we have to, for this, we have to just imagine beyond the unit cell. Okay, and for the HCP also the same coordination number, and therefore we got the same effective packing fraction. For FCC and HCP, coordination number is same, and therefore its packing fraction is also same. Now from this, if I write one more here for the diamond, what is the coordination number? 4. Effective number atoms are 8, and what we got is the 34% is what the packing factor. Okay, so yes, just talk about the coordination number column, because everything we already have seen. So coordination number, if we talk about the coordination number, just look at the coordination number and packing factor. Coordination number and packing factor. As packing factor or as coordination number is more, packing factor is also more, right? If coordination number is less, then packing factor is also less. So moreover, if the coordination number is 4, so minimum is this the coordination number among all these. So what we got, the minimum packing factor, that is 34%. Right, and maximum coordination number, yes, maximum coordination number for HCP and FCC, so the maximum packing factor, that is 74%. So in general, if the coordination number is less than 12, if the coordination number for a unit cell is less than 12, then that is structure or that unit cell is known as loosely packed unit cell. So since our diamond is also having less coordination number, it is 4 only, and its packing factor is 34, that is why we called diamond as a loosely packed structure. Yes, simple cubic is also loosely packed, body center is also loosely packed, even though the packing factors are greater than the our diamond. Yes, diamond for simple cubic it is 52, for body center it is 68. It is, yes, obviously greater than diamond, greater than 34%. But yes, that whether the structure is closely packed or loosely packed decides by this coordination number. So what is the condition? If coordination number is equal to or greater than 12, equal to or greater than 12, then only we can say that is that then only greater than or equal to 12, then only we can say, sorry, if the coordination number is greater than or equal to 12, then that structure is closely packed. So our FCC is closely packed, HCP is also closely packed, but simple cubic, body centered and diamond are not closely packed. And since NaCl have the FCC structure whose coordination number is 12 and whose packing factor is 74, therefore our NaCl is also a closely packed structure. Okay, so I hope you got what I want to say you, and rightly, yes, at the last we can say thank you, because this is what the end of our first unit. Here in this unit we have seen all about our crystal structure, okay, all about our different type of crystals, different types of two dimensional and three dimensional structures, and moreover some specific structures we have seen like NaCl and diamond and hexagonal close packed and FCC and BCC. For that we have found the coordination number, effective number of atoms and packing factor also. So guys, yes, this is all for the today's video, and if you really like this video, if you feel that this is really helpful for your value addition in your knowledge, then please like this video, and for more such videos just subscribe to my channel Physics for You, and yes, press the notification icon so that you will get the notification of my next videos. So thank you guys, just take care and keep learning. We'll meet in the next video very soon. Thank you.